Hello, welcome to Media Pool. I'm Yuanmo. This is my first video essay for the viral video module. In this video essay, I will use Moon's model to critically reflect on my art projects. In the part 1, I will use Berger's theories to analyze the textual characteristics of individual video and group video. And then I will use top-down strategies to compare the viral projects of two projects and find the reasons of why the videos achieved different level of virality. Then, in the part 2, I will use Turkman and Goldman's theories to reflect on the development of my teamwork and leadership skills. Finally, I will summarize what I have learned from this module. According to Berger's state framework, I will use social currency, particular value, public, and triggers to analyze the two videos. Now, let's start the first part. When I started out this module, I thought viral video is about the subject of how to make a short video popular. So I decided to study this module. According to Burgess and Green, found that the most popular form of user-created video across all categories was the vlog. I was already interested in travel vlogs before studying this course. So for my individual video, I chose to create a travel vlog to introduce my hometown. And I think because people can travel anywhere else during a pandemic, travel vlogs will grab the attention of viewers more than usual. For this project, I used digital marketing's brief showing with audience the city of Xi'an. I think my individual project demonstrates understanding of video production techniques with something interesting video and audio material and some use graphics, but there are some drawbacks in my video. Firstly, my video is mainly a travel montage and I have very little interaction with the audience. Therefore, these types of videos provoke little engagement amongst viewers. Secondly, my promotion plan was short and I didn't have a clear plan which takes account of audience, commentators, and channels. Okay, next, let's move on to the group video project. Our group project is talked about how to make e-learning video go viral. For social currency, our video gives intel on the viral video module and the kind of work students will be doing at university. This information is not widely accessible and it will give viewers insider knowledge about the course that they might share with their friends and family interested in the topic or studying the topic at the university. For particular value, our video uses clean narration, smooth animation, and a high number of visual representations to make academic theories accessible and understandable. For public, as our video shows research and work by the media and communication students, it will provide more information to students who are interested in the department and the university. For triggers, e-learning is very current due to the epidemic and the need for teachers to adapt to e-learning styles. So people may be searching this topic more than usual. But we didn't manage to include much emotion. If creating a longer video, the inclusion of more emotionally stimulating narrative techniques, such as interviews with students, would likely make the video even more appealing to a wider audience. For promotion plan, I think our group project has a good understanding of top-down strategies and we have a clear plan to promote our videos on social media. For example, we took account of audience, commentators, and channels of different platforms. Because the video is not only for UK students and their parents, but also for international students and their parents. So taking account of various age audience, We plan to post our video on YouTube and promote to on the Department of Media and Communications LinkedIn, Twitter and Instagram accounts, as well as our own personal Weibo accounts. For competitors, we think other universities who have the same or similar department that wish to attract more potential students. Comparing the views of my personal videos to the views of the group videos, I think the group videos are more viral. In my project, as of now, the group video has 113 views, but my personal video has less views. I think in my project, I didn't have a good understanding of how to make a viral travel vlog. According to lecture notes, a good video blog needs to meet the following three aspects. The first one is destination image. The second one is tourist gate. The third one is the circle of representation. In group project, I need to research for a promotion plan. With the help of some of the group members and my in-depth knowledge of the top-down strategies, I understood that moment how I could go about making a clear plan to effectively promote our videos on social media. To improve in the future, I need to pay attention to the brief and course materials. Great effort in planning, production, and promotion. In the part 2, we encountered a variety of issues during the production process of our video. Due to the epidemic, we quickly realized that we had to delegate individual production tasks that won't relate on multiple people. In the forming stage, we referred to our skilled audience with deciding who would take on the filming task. However, when examining skilled audience, we very few had rated skills above a 3 on scale. This post shows an early absence of trust within the group, highlighted by Lenny Coney as one of the 5 dysfunctions of a team, as members didn't feel confident enough to share their skills. In storming stage, we had some problems because of the unclear goals and strategies. We faced this one several options when individuals were unsure of how to approach their task or what was actually required. Our risk management worked well in this section, as we were all able to return to tasks that individuals had struck with and establish clear goals and methods of how to achieve them. To deal with this issue, we had a group conversation about who feel comfortable being on camera and who feels their skills were better used in other areas. This ended up being a more effective method at driving growth and helped our group move into norming stage. I think that in future group projects, I should build up trust with group members beforehand so that they get to know each other better. It is then that defined goal can be established and good progress should be made towards this goal. Actively participate in group meetings and provide constructive feedback. This will make the early stages of production run more smoothly and make it easier for us to work to deadlines. Looking back now, I think this course helped me understanding of viral media stories. That's all for me now. If you enjoy this video, please like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.